Before I became a parent, I didn't quite comprehend that if you put a toddler or baby in bed, that you can't actually force it to go to sleep. Even if said child is exhausted and eyes are rolling back into its little head, the small human will cling to the waking state like a suicide jumper clinging to the side of the building for a while holding his life. But unlike a jumper situation, there is no skill, smooth talk, and professional that is just what to say at bedtime. Nope, it's just me and I'm exhausted. I thought one too many vows on this day, from putting on the same little shoes to less than 20 times, to avoiding stairs and sharp little objects, I just want it to end. I'm actually that asshole on the screen. Go ahead, freaky jump! I don't care! Just leave me alone! My frustration, my own children, alarms even me. It doesn't start out that way. Every night starts out too bad, but it should be. Sweet routine and enjoyable into the day. But after bedtime and teeth brushing, more bedtime stories, a few rounds of you are my sunshine and kumbaya, I'm ready to give you that last goodnight kiss and come enjoy being an adult. As I pack those chirp cheeks and turn to leave, it starts. Please sleep with me, Mommy. I miss you today. Sometimes I stand firm and I say no, which sets a whole different chain of evidence into action. But I'm not going to say tonight with all the sweetness and desire to cuddle my kids and enjoy them dripping off into fantasies. Shh, I soothe. I snuggle down next to my child and control my breathing into a peaceful coup. Keep in mind, while the singing and reading and shooshing is going on, I have folded my body into a midget bed, roughly 3 feet long and 2 feet wide. Along with a myriad of stuffed animals and nighttime friends. After what feels like an hour has passed since lights out, I peek at my watch to discover it's only been 15 minutes. An army of thoughts and things I still need to accomplish before I can put myself to bed march through my mind. But finally, I hear the breathing slow into that rhythm zone that signals the fight is finally over. Victory is mine. I did not stop off during bedtime. Slowly rise from the bed when a little arm reaches up and grabs my arm. Not to be easily dismissed. I wait until there's softness and then I try again. I tiptoe and hold my breath, finally exhaling as my foot touches into the hallway. When a soft voice pierces the darkness, Mommy, sleep with me! It's time for bed, baby. I do.
And yes, again, for all you parents out there that have kids to your restroom and have a 500 bar before bed, and then they go to bed and actually go to sleep. We did use the bathroom and have a 500 bar before bedtime, but the bedtime was an hour and a half ago, and kindergarten doesn't use his potty in a different bar. So now I understand that stupid 90s campaign, never ever shave a baby. Who would shave a baby? I don't remember my child was telling me something about baby. Me! I'll shave a baby! I'll shave both the babies right now! And then I'm gonna go to sleep! You're laughing because you don't have to talk to Jennifer, or you do have to talk to Jennifer. And so, I take a few deep breaths, and I remind myself that one day I have missed holding myself around their perfect little bodies and soft skin, and I reminisce how sweet this smiley really is. But for now, I cynically report back to my post, and I surrender to softness and nurturing and mothering. I fall peacefully into a slumber right next to my legs. All week, few hours later, stiff neck and dry contacts glued in my brilliant eyes, and snuggled in my own bed for a few hours of sleep before they will inevitably wander in to join me. Honestly, I never did figure out a perfect bedtime routine. My kids just outgrew the toddler bedtime works. But for those of you still surviving the days of a go at the clock to sleep, there is hope on the horizon. Just too tired to see it, and I have no advice other than stay strong. This too shall pass.